Hi friends, today I am going to show you how we can create a simple game using Angular. This is the game I have created and I have named this game as Fill with Dots. When you move your mouse inside this box, you can see the box is getting filled with colorful dots. Also, you can see a countdown timer. To win this game, you have to fill the entire box with dots before the timer runs out. If you miss to fill any space, you will lose. I have deployed this game and provided the link in the description. You can try and let me know in the comment section whether you managed to win. Okay, now I'm going to recreate this application and explain how I created this. First, let me create a new Angular application. ng new filled with dots. Let me choose S here. I don't want routing. Let me choose no. And let me choose SESS. Now application is getting created. Let's wait. Okay, it is created. Let me start the server and open this in VS Code. We can see the server has started, and so let me open this in browser. We can see this. As a first step, let me correct the title in the index.html, and in the global style CSS, let me add some code to reset the browser default styles. And in app component HTML, let me delete everything and creating a div. Inside that, let me create one h1 tag. And in CSS, let me add some styles so that the title appears in the center. Now we can see this. In HTML, let me create a game container div. In CSS, for the game container div, let me give width 845 pixel, height 363 pixel, padding 20 pixel, margin 0 pixel auto so that it appears in the center, border 2 pixel solid and purple color, border radius 5 pixel, and overflow hidden. I have tried different values for width and height and finally found these values are correct. Inside the game container div, I am going to create another div. Let me add a class dot. And in component, let me use array.from to create 160 items. I have tried with different values and found 160 is the right number. Now in HTML, let me use ng-for to generate 160 dots. For the dot class, let me give width 40 pixel, height 40 pixel, border radius 50% so that it will be changed to a circle, and let me use float left so that all divs will be displayed side by side, and let me add a color for now, so that we can see the dots. In the HTML, let me have a mouse over event, and I am binding that to a function. And let me use a template reference variable and pass that reference to the function. Let me also create this function in the component. And let me create a colors array and have 10 colors. And let me also create a variable, random color index. Initially, I am assigning it to 0. Inside change style function, first let me create a random number between 0 and 9 and assigning that to the random color index variable. And then I am adding a class to the dot reference so that when we mouse over, a random color class will be added to the dot div. Let me also add these classes in the CSS. You can see I have just added a respective background color and I have used a transition so that it slowly transforms to the new color. Now we can see on mouse over the color of the dot is getting changed. This is the time to remove the temporary color we added. Let me change it to white. Okay, our game is almost ready. Let's make it more interesting by adding a timer. First, let me create a result div below this game container div. And inside result, let me add a div to show a counter. Let me also create this counter variable and initialize that to 25 because we need to count down from 25. Okay, it is coming here. Let me add some CSS so that it appears clearly. Okay, looks good. Now let me create a function start timer, and inside that let me use set interval to decrement the counter every 1 second. And to test this, let me call this start timer function in onInit. Also, let me create a new variable myInterval and get this interval. In onDestroy, let me clear this interval. Now we can see the countdown timer has started. But actually, we should not start it immediately after the application loads. We have to start it only after the user mouse over the first dot. So instead of onInit, let me move that inside changeStyle function. But here also we have a problem. When I mouse over the first dot, we can see the timer has started. But if I mouse over more dots, the timer is running fast because this function is getting called multiple times. That is not right. So let me introduce a new variable isGameStarted and initializing that to false. Once the start timer function is called, I'm changing that to true. And I'm going to call the start timer only if the isGameStarted flag is false, so that it will be called only one time. So now we can see it is working fine. Also, we need to track the game status after every mouse over action. So let me create a new function, checkGameStatus. And instead of calling startTimer here, let me call checkGameStatus and let me call startTimer inside this checkGameStatus function. To track the game status after every mouse over action, we need to check the number of dots already filled and yet to be filled. So let me introduce two new variables, cleanCount and dirtyCount. And let me initialize both as 0. I am going to reset it to 0 inside checkGameStatus function also. Now I need to get the reference of all dots to check whether it has a new class added or not. So let me use @viewChildren like this. And inside checkGameStatus, let me loop through all the dots using forEach and checking whether it has a new class added or not. If the length is greater than 1, I am increasing the dirty count. Otherwise, I'm increasing the clean count. Now we need to find out whether the game is ended or not. The game can be ended when the timer runs out or when the user fills all the dots before the timer runs out. So let me create a new variable isGameEnded. Inside startTimer function, instead of decrementing it directly, let me check whether the counter has reached 0. If not, I'm decrementing it. When it reaches 0, let me change the isGameEnded flag to true. So we have covered one scenario. And inside checkGameStatus, let's check whether the dirty count is reached to 160. That means whether all the dots have filled. In that case, let's change the isGameEnded flag to true. In this case, user has won. And so let's also introduce a new flag isWon and change it to true here. That's it. Now we need to show the result. Coming back to the HTML, here, first let me add a condition to show the counter only after the game starts and hide it after the game ends. And another div to show an info to user when the game has not started and not ended. And another div to inform user if the user wins the game. And finally, one more div to inform user how many dots user has missed. That's it. Let me test it. I lost. But I can fill the dots even after I lose. So let's allow to fill only if the game is not ended. Now it is good. Let me try again. This time I won. Don't forget to try this game in the deployed version. The link is in the description. And I'll be happy if you develop this game on your own by following this video. If you want the code, you can get it from the GitHub link in the description. And please don't forget to subscribe and support me. I'll be back with another concept soon. Thank you. Bye.